Lindsay and Lee are our staff divers. They leave our Carlsbad office pretty early in the morning and head up to the Dana Point Harbor.
They've headed on out to Wheeler North Reef, where they're monitoring the reef community. At 373 acres, Wheeler North Reef is the largest artificial reef in the world. Our crew spends a lot of time underwater, about 650 dive hours every year. They're in the water 2 to 3 hours a day, and each day they complete at least 2 or 3 dives. This reef was constructed as mitigation to compensate for impacts due to the San Onofre Nuclear Generating Station, which is a nuclear power plant located in San Clemente, California, which you've probably noticed if you're driving down the I-5.
When the power plant is bringing in ocean water to cool the nuclear reactors, that water is warmed to about 19 degrees above ambient seawater temperature. And so to slowly cool that water, it's pushed back into the ocean through these diffuser pipes. Those diffuser pipes caused a turbidity plume, and a turbidity plume just means basically it's stirring up sediment and making the water murky.
Kelp, they need to photosynthesize, and so actually those large turbid water plumes were blocking sunlight and limiting the ability of baby kelp to establish.
That turbidity plume caused the loss of the San Onofre kelp forest and the associated community. Wheeler North Reef is compensation for those lost marine resources.
The power plant operated for 32 years, and so the California Coastal Commission determined that 32 years of credit would be needed for successful mitigation.
When we built Wheeler North Reef, we wanted to make sure that it was functioning similar to what a natural reef would function like. You want to make sure that the habitat you're creating is doing what nature would do naturally. And so what we do is we look at the community and we compare the community at Wheeler North Reef to two nearby natural reference reefs. We monitor all three reefs concurrently on an annual basis. Kelp forests are really important because they provide a whole bunch of ecosystem services and functions that we as humans benefit from. And maybe that's a human-centric approach to why we care about them instead of just their intrinsic beautiful value. Kelp forests are known as nursery habitat for fishes and invertebrates that are recreationally and commercially harvested. So if you've ever had a crab roll, even in San Bernardino, right? That is probably from some marine environment that could have included a kelp forest.
I'm not a diver myself, but I do spend a lot of time looking at the data. I've been amazed by the number of species that our divers are able to collect, hundreds of species that encompass the entire reef community. Looking at those data sets, you really can see changes over time, and so we're often looking at how quickly different members of the reef are recovering. We saw fish attracted to the reef within the first year post-construction, and over time we've seen other members of the community building up, including those invertebrate communities and macroalgae as well. We saw kelp recruit to the reef in that first year and then grow up into a lush kelp canopy within 2 to 3 years. It's really amazing to see the transformation of the reef over time.
Artificial reefs can play a role and be one of the tools in the toolbox for how we might restore or create habitat that kelp can then colonize. But it's important that whatever we do is really based on the best available science. There was a lot of thought and a lot of science that went into the design of the artificial reef. When the rock is dropped, there's nothing living on it. And you're like, okay, is anything going to colonize? Is any life going to occur here? Because it's just rock. Right?
There were a lot of things that we didn't know about artificial reefs when this project started. We didn't know that kelp would be able to establish on a new reef.
To see that rock transform into a kelp forest community over years, it is an incredibly hopeful story.
I feel like oftentimes from the surface, we don't realize these amazing forests that we have underneath the water. This is like one of the most urbanized, highly developed areas in the world. Knowing that just offshore, we have this amazing underwater resource that not a lot of people get to see is really special.
There's always something new or exciting.
Yeah, the cool thing is we slow down and we look at the tiny things too. We're counting tiny nudibranchs and tiny sea snails, and it's fun to see new stuff every year.
I think we usually come up from every dive with like one thing that we were really excited about, or that was the biggest sea cucumber I've ever seen. Like, you know, so.
That was the highlight
today.
That
was today.